In this video, we are going to solve problem 2-31 from RC Hibbeler Engineering Statics 12th edition. Particular problem, three cables pull on the pipe such that they create a resultant force having a magnitude of 900 lb. Two of the cables are subjected to known forces as shown in the figure. Determine the angle theta of the third cable so that the magnitude of force F in this cable is a minimum. All forces lie in the xy plane. What is the magnitude of F? We are also given a hint. First, find the resultant of the two known forces. What two known forces are? Let's call this F1 and F2. F1 equals 600 lb. F2 is 400 lb. To find the resultant of these two known forces, we have to use parallelogram law. So to use parallelogram law, we have to draw a parallelogram using these vectors. What I have to do is extend these vectors. Also this one, let's label them. This is the projection of F1 force, this is the projection of F2 force. Let's call this vector is the resultant of these two forces F dash. So to find F dash, what we have to do, we have to find some angles which are one angle is right here, another is right here, here and here. Let's call this alpha, this angle is also alpha, this is beta. Also we can find alpha. We know that a quadrant is 90 degree, so if 45 degree is covered, so what we are left with, we are left with 45 in this portion and 30 in this portion, this red portion which is showing an angle 45 degrees. So alpha equals 45 plus 30 degrees, alpha is 75 degrees. We can find beta. We know that the sum of interior angles of a quadrilateral is 360 degrees. Now beta equals 360 minus 2 times alpha divided by 2. Beta equals 105 degrees. You can easily find this F dash. For F dash, we are going to use cosine law. F dash equals square root of F1 square plus F2 square minus 2 times F1 F2. Cos 105. F dash equals, we know F1 which is 600 lb plus F2 400 lb minus 2 times 600 400 cos 105 degrees. F dash equals 802.64 lb. Here comes the interesting part. This resultant F dash and the force F this force are collinear. Why? Because they both are forming the diagonal of this parallelogram. So these two lines are collinear. So our resultant Fr equal F dash plus F. We can write here that F dash and F are collinear because they are forming a diagonal of the parallelogram also. They both also all the forces which are F1, F2 and F3 are concurrent, right? They will remain concurrent on the opposite vertex. They will remain concurrent on the opposite vertex, which is only possible if F dash and F are collinear. Like these three forces F1, F and F2 are concurrent to this point, which is origin. So they will remain concurrent on the opposite of the of this vertex. I hope you will find this understanding helpful. If you still have any doubts, you can mention them in the comment section. I will explain it again. This given, which is 900 lb minus f dash 802.64 lb equals f. F equals 97.36 lb. This is our first answer. We are also asked to find this angle theta, which is right here. Now we can say that if I select an angle, let's remove this. I'm drawing it right here. At this angle is, let's call this phi. Now phi equals theta plus 30 degrees, and this theta, and we know the opposite side, and we also know this angle theta and the opposite side. So we can use here sine law. From the sine law, sine pi over f1 600 equal sine theta over fr, which is 802.64. We can put the values of theta here, which is theta equals 105 degrees. From here phi equals 46.2 degrees. But our goal is to find theta. So if we put the value of phi in this equation, let's call this equation A. From here theta equals 46.22 minus 30 degrees, 16.22 degrees. our second answer. I hope you will find this video helpful. If you do, please feel free to subscribe this channel and also turn on the bell icon for daily updates. It will help my channel to grow up. Thank you.